welcome to Peaky Boardgamer. My name is Efirakos, and this will be a slightly different video than the rest. This is gonna be a rules overview of the Lost Ruins of Arnak. This video skips setup details and examples to give you a grasp of the rules in a more condensed duration. All important parts are in this video, however, if you want to see the more detailed video, click at the link up there. Now let's start. In the game, players are trying to find the Lost Ruins of Arnak until the next full moon, that is, in 5 days rounds of the game. Each round starts with players drawing cards from their personal decks, and then we have the main action phase where players take turns clockwisely, performing actions until all players have passed. Then there is a short preparation phase before the next round begins. In the beginning of each round, players draw cards from their piles until they have a starting hand of 5 cards. These will be the cards they will be using throughout the round. Players will be playing cards, and when they do so, they can take advantage either of the travel value or the effect. In phase 2, starting with the first player and then clockwise order, players take turns performing one main action and any number of free actions before, after, or during their main action. Free actions are designated by the symbol of a lightning, which can be found on cards or on tiles in the game. Digging at a site involves placing one of the player's available archaeologists on his personal board to a site space and then receiving the site's bonuses. To perform the action, the player must pay the travel cost depicted on it. To pay for this cost, the player has to spend any number of cards from his hand played face up in front of his play area for the travel value. There are 4 types of transportational costs. We have boots, boats, cars, and planes. Plane cards can be used to pay for all other costs. Car icons can be used to pay for boots, and the same counts for boats. After the player pays the cost, he receives all the bonuses depicted in the bottom of the site. With the Discover a New Site action, the player discovers a new site and digs it as well in one action. The cost for this action will be compasses depending on the site location the player will discover, but also transportational costs in order for the player to send his archaeologist there. The player then gains all idle tiles existing in the newly discovered site and gains all the bonuses depicted. As a free action, a player may place one of his idols to the leftmost empty idle space of his board and then receive one of the 5 different bonuses depicted on the left. Then the player draws the top tile from the corresponding site level and places it on that spot and gains immediately all the bonuses depicted in the bottom of that site. As the last step, the player also draws the top guardian tile from the stack and places it on top of the new site. With the Overcome a Guardian action, the player can eliminate a guardian that exists on a site where one of his archaeologists is located. To do so, the player must pay the costs depicted in the bottom of the guardian tile, and then he picks up the tile and places it next to his player board. Guardian tiles offer a boon effect to the player that acquires them, however, it can be used only once in the game. With a Buy a Card action, players acquire new cards for their decks from the card market. The cost is compasses for artifacts and coins for items. Whenever a player buys an item card, this card is placed in the bottom of the player's draw pile. But when the player buys an artifact, this is placed in the player's play area and the effect is immediately triggered. After buying the card, the empty space in the market is immediately replenished with a card from the corresponding stack. As an action, a player can also play a card from his hand on his play area and carry out the effect described on that card. However, when an artifact card is played from the player's hand, he must also pay a rune tablet as an extra cost. With Research Main Action, players move one of their research tokens to the next level, seeking to find the Lost Temple before the end of the game. Each player has 2 research tokens, a magnifying glass and a notebook. To move the notebook, it must be in a lower level than the player's magnifying glass. A player must also spend the resources depicted in the bridge that connects the player's current location to the next one. After moving the token, players collect all the bonuses on an existing bonus tile, but also the bonus depicted on the right side of the row, depending on the token they have just moved. With the Gain a New Assistant bonus, the player acquires a new assistant from the top of any stack and places it in the corresponding space on their personal board. Assistants offer various effects that can be used by the players by tapping them. With the upgrade and assistant bonus, the player flips one of his assistants to the other side, and if the tile was exhausted, he also refreshes it. When the player's magnifying glass reaches the top level, it is placed in the leftmost empty space of the row. The player also collects the bonuses of one bonus tile on the right and discards the tile. In the future, when the player moves his magnifying glass, he will instead buy temple tiles. Under the tiles, there are three different resource costs. Depending on the tile he's buying, the player will have to pay a specific combination of these resource boxes. As a main action, the player may also pass. Until the end of the player turn's phase, their turn will be skipped. The player turn's phase ends as soon as all players have taken the pass main action. When the round ends, perform the following steps in that order. First, all players take back their archaeologists from the board. When a player takes his archaeologist from a site that contains a guardian, then he must also take a fear card from the supply, which he places in his play area. Now, if the player has any cards remaining in his hand, he may either discard them as well in his play area or keep them for the next round. In any case, after this point, the player shuffles all the cards in his play area and places them in the bottom of his draw pile. Players then refresh all their exhausted assistants. In the card draw, exile the two cards on either side of the moon staff. Then move the staff one space to the right and refill the empty spaces as normal. Finally, the first player token is passed to the next player clockwisely and the next round begins. In scoring, players gain victory points depending on the level acquired by both of their research tokens. They score victory points depicted on their temple tiles, 3 victory points for each one of their idols, the victory points depicted in the empty idol spaces of their board, 5 victory points for each one of their guardian tiles, and the victory points depicted on all of their cards. The player that acquired the most victory points in the game is declared the winner.